You two alright, so today I got this Nissan Quest with blending on the door fender, and then I got the bumper. So the last video when I was showing with the LPH 400, I've noticed that I did not have my camera correctly positioned. So I said I was gonna make another one with another silver and do it from there. So I'm gonna spray this up with the LPH 400 perfect cap. That's what I have here. And I'm gonna spray this up. This one is a little bit more bigger job than the last video. This one is bigger, so you able to get kind of a real feel of it. Seeing the real feel of it because I have bigger panels. Got the fender, the bumper, and the door to blend on, which on the other video I just had just the fender and the bumper, and it was just, you know, just a little bit of paint that just had to be on it, while this have more of a full thing. So I'm gonna spray this up for y'all, let y'all see how it comes out and everything like that. I'm shooting this at 12 psi, 3 inches, just about it. So I'm gonna go ahead and get it started. First coat right here is dry, and if you want to, you can put another coat on if you want to. So like I had said with with that gun, it don't really spit it out so much. So, you know, by the time you do something like this and you come back to it, it's just about dry. So if you want to, you can put another one on. See? So we're gonna spray another one on, and then after that, we're gonna let it dry. We'll let it dry. So you just 3 inches, shoot it 3 inches. Once you get coverage, you can come back 6 inches and do it from there. Also, you have to make sure that your fan pattern is really matching the panel, because if it's not matching the panel, it can start striping. Like right here, I couldn't get it to the pattern to go right because I was so close to this fender, so it'll start striping like this. So you have to make sure that your fan pattern is equal. You leveling it out onto the panel and you'll be good. So let's go ahead and put another one on. All right. About to spray the second coat on. Well, it's basically like the third coat because we did like a tech coat, and then we did a heavy coat. We're gonna make it as a second, fuck it. So we're gonna put another coat on. This gonna be our last coat of being 3 inches just because we got good enough coverage with it. So this gonna be the last coat that we do 3 inches, and then it'll be 12 PSI. To go 6 inches after this, so we're gonna let it dry up and y'all will see how good it'll start looking once you go 6 inches. So we got coverage, it looks good. Next, still 12 psi. Once we come back, we're gonna still do 12 psi, and we're just gonna step it 6 inches, and that's it. And it'll come out beautiful, y'all will see. But so, I'm gonna let that flash, and I'll see y'all on the next one. All right, it's time to shoot it. 6 inches on this one, and still 12 PSI, so we're gonna go ahead and get it started because I'll be doing too much damn talking. that was all of it. I done ran down, but 6 inches. They done laid it down. And all we gotta do is just wait for it to dry. We can go ahead and clear it. So it's just simple. Like I said, I'm gonna have to make a video one day on doing the hood so I can show y'all how that works. Cause I know, you know, if y'all do have the LPH 400 and the purple cap and you try to do hoods, you may have issue with tiger striping and stuff like that. So I'll probably make a video on doing just the hood where I'm doing metallic on it, and to help y'all out to keep from having tiger stripes or anything like that with that gun, because you will be getting tiger stripes off the hood when you spraying it, just because, you know, you just, like, it's just a flat panel and it ain't no way that it can move and stuff. So it is a way for you to be able to get the tiger stripes out with that gun. Yeah, this is the finished product of this. We're gonna let it dry and then we're gonna clear it. We're gonna clear it with the DV1 with the C2 cap, 1.4 tip. And yeah, so I'll see y'all when I'm ready to clear. All right, let's tack it down. We can go ahead and get started. I really don't have to check all this, but just to show that, you know, it's good. I'm gonna go ahead and start on this. Like I always preach, 1.5 turns out with this 22 PSI. That's it. So, this is all the way closed going that way. 1, and then 1.5. Wide open fan, 22 PSI. All right.